Motivated behaviors are voluntary behaviors that individuals find rewarding or pleasurable. Certain behaviors or stimuli, like food or sex, are naturally rewarding because they are necessary for the survival of a species. They are adaptive, and the nervous system has evolved to make these behaviors pleasurable. Rewarding stimuli increases brain activation in brain regions that comprise the reward circuit. The reward circuit depends on the action of dopamine. Dopamine is synthesized and released by neurons located in the ventral tegmental area, a midbrain region adjacent to the substantia nigra. And remember the substantia nigra from the basal ganglia chapter. There are two primary pathways from the ventral tegmental area that are important for reward. The mesolimbic pathway connects the ventral tegmental area to the nucleus accumbens, a region located in the ventral striatum. Again, remember the basal ganglia chapter. The mesocortical pathway connects the ventral tegmental area with the prefrontal cortex. Early experimental studies showed that rodents with an electrode placed along these dopaminergic pathways will complete tasks, like a bar press, to self-stimulate the regions. Rats will show a marked increase in the behavior compared to controls. Often, the animals would forego other behaviors, like eating, to continue pressing the bar. Treatment with drugs that block the receptors for dopamine reduce the self-stimulating behavior, indicating that dopamine is the critical neurotransmitter involved in making the stimulation of these brain regions rewarding. However, continued research suggests that the connection between dopamine release and reward may not be as simple as the self-stimulation studies imply. It appears that it is not the reward itself that increases dopamine, but the predicted expectation of the reward. Dopamine signaling increases during anticipation of a predicted reward. If the level of the reward is more than predicted, reward learning occurs, and dopamine signaling and motivation to repeat that behavior increases. If the level of reward is less than predicted, then dopamine signaling decreases, as does motivation to repeat the behavior. Natural rewards that increase survival and fitness of a species activate the reward circuit. These behaviors and stimuli include certain food, like those containing high sugar or fat levels, social bonding, parental bonding, and sex. Most drugs of abuse also activate the reward circuit and dopamine signaling, which plays a critical role in the formation of addiction. For example, dopamine effects are typically terminated by reuptake into the presynaptic terminal via the dopamine transporter. Cocaine blocks the transporter, preventing reuptake of dopamine. The increased action of dopamine on the nucleus accumbens leads to increased activation of the reward circuit, a mechanism underlying addiction to the drug. Other drugs like heroin and nicotine increase dopamine release from the ventral tegmental area, which also extends dopamine effects on neurons in the nucleus accumbens.